with a user-defined record number in one table and update the data based on the user-defined time parameter. So you can specify the record and a record parameter and the time when you want to extract. So likewise, you can do that for bulk extraction. I want to show you some after this, I want to show you some console for these applications. So the throttle limit is basically it's a limit or defined by the source API system. Here in our case is LinkedIn, is our source API system. And every entity has a certain limits that the user can query for. So, and it varies for a different entity. So in your NoSQL, you can pass the throttle limit parameter to dynamically fetch the data. So here we can dynamically fetch the data and we can pass the throttle limit. So every system, the source API system has a throttle limit, which constrains you to pull the data sequentially, basically. So in your NoSQL, different entities has a default throttle limit set. So your user need not specifically the limit the while running the applications. So this is a console which I talked about. This is a desktop version of that console, NoSQL, where you can specify the parameter and it pulls the information. It's a single data set as well as bulk data set. Also, we can include the time parameter in it. So you can also have the updated data. You can also delete the data as well. So from the LinkedIn. So you can also specify the default single XML data extraction. Here, for example, I give four as a language. We extract the language parameter as like this. So we extract the language XML data into the folder. It can be the drive, the cloud drive, as well as your local system. So this is how it looks in the local system, for example. So now you're, so you have XML data where you have the directory structure languages and the language XML, which you can see. Suppose if you have more records, so you get to see language 1 and language 2 and language 3, so on and so forth. So this is the data orchestration part of it, where you have the Excel sheet in place, where it basically get into these folders, XML folders, and pull the data, basically. So we can have the macro here. So you have the load, click on the load data, it extract all the data set from the LinkedIn. So we have a base connections, base current share, and you have all other entities as well. So if you wanted to have a, if you wanted to pull separate entities, you can do that by importing into the Excel sheet one by one. So this is the data look like for a language, you know, for ID and ID3. So ID3 is basically is a unique number for a particular person ID. So so after this, we have import the Excel sheet into the data source. Basically, here in our case is AccessDB, where we import these as a base data for us to query against these data. So you have different parameters where you know you have different macros. Sorry, We have different macros where you can run your query. So you have a data insert and also data addition as well. So if you can see here, you can also have an executed insert SQL where it bulk insert the data from the LinkedIn. Here is the final output of the AccessDB where you you transfer all the data from base language from the Excel sheet linkable table to the language table. So this is an implementation of your know your kin basically. So you have the client component where you have a kin contact as a client component. It basically contact the remote component in the drive basically. So you have the kin contact, kin extract which has the link to the actual resource know your kin and access store resources. So from there, we basically pull all the XML data into the directory structure. And the data orchestration is done in Excel sheet as shown in the previous slides. So these Excel data has been orchestrated in the Excel sheet and put in into different DBs, includes Access as well. So